Hi, everyone, and welcome to the News Agent Podcast. I'm Susie Lysett, Content Manager at Goodlord. In today's episode, we'll be taking a look at what tenants and landlords look for in a modern letting agent, looking at those different characteristics and see what it is that they really want and need at the minute. So to help me on that front, I'm joined by David Phillips, the director at Propfinity. So thanks for joining me today, David.
And thank you for having me, Suzanne. I appreciate the call, and I look forward to getting stuck in.
Me too. I think it's quite an interesting topic, and obviously it will be useful for our listeners out there just to have an understanding really as to your experience with what landlords and tenants are both looking for. Obviously, the reason that I'm talking to you about this topic is that your agency, Propfinity, it's a cloud-based lettings and property management agency. So it's quite involved in being quite forward-looking, I suppose. But just to kick us off, if you wouldn't mind just telling us a bit about you, your agency, and obviously how that particular angle kind of came about.
Yeah, absolutely. So, yeah, my name's David Phillips, director at Propfinity, which is a online slash cloud based slash digital virtual agency, whichever term you sort of prefer. But look, the basic premise of the agency is that we're based online. We don't have any high street branches or anything like that. So we are trying to do things a little bit different. The company is in its infancy. It's about 18 months old now. And in that time, we've managed to build a portfolio to a medium size with a reasonable size. And we're still charging on to try and make this a nationwide business. But at the moment, we're based in sort of London, Essex area. And yeah, that's the company. I mean, yeah, basically and essentially, it's an online estate agency, and we're trying to give landlords an experience that's different from what is typically given on the high street.
Now, that sounds fantastic. And with you being a relatively new company, if I may ask, because I think it's relevant to ask, what exactly it was that prompted you to start, especially with this digital focus?
Well, I think I started my career on the high street in central London, sort of Tower Bridge area. And that was my first sort of experience. Shortly after, I moved to various different companies, all that were on the high street. And then the pandemic happened eventually. And the pandemic is probably the point where I started to realize, actually, what we are doing as an industry can be done in a different way. I worked for a particular company, and during the pandemic, we was actually working from home. So obviously we weren't allowed to go out and meet with members of the public and things like that. And we were still managing to give landlords the service that they're paying for. So that kind of opened my eyes. And I'm sure a lot of companies, I don't think this is just something that's, unique to the property industry. I think a lot of industries started to realize, hang on a second, a lot of the things and services that we're providing to our clients can actually be overcome with a bit of technology. So that was probably the start and the catalyst for me to think, you know what, actually, I want to go out there on my own and give clients something unique and something different. And that's just the way the world is going in general. A lot of things are, going online, tech-based. And I think over the last probably 20 to 30 years, we've seen a lot of companies that were on the high street disappear, not just in property. I'm sure if you cast your mind maybe 15 years back, you remember Blockbuster. You used to go in and get your videotapes on rent and stuff like that, but we've got Netflix now. So that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to be the Netflix, if you like, of the property industry in the UK.
That's it. That's a pretty strong image. That's a good thing to aim for. I think they're quite successful. So,
absolutely.
And within this then, because obviously you've taken this decision to sort of shift online, not necessarily have that high street presence. I mean, what kind of touch points do you have with your customers? Whether it's online, whether it's face-to-face, do you have any face-to-face contact? How does that work?
Well, we do have various different touch points. So one of them, we do a lot of video calls, right? So some of our valuations that we do for our clients are actually just done via Zoom. Typically, you would go to a property, you'd get the tour, the landlord or the owner of the property will take you around the property, give you a tour and all of those things. That can be completed via a Zoom call, and you can get into as much detail as you would when you're there and there with the landlord. So yeah, we do use a lot of video calls. Not all of our valuations are done by video, but if that's the landlord's preference, then by all means, that's what we provide for them. So video call-in, same again with tenants. If there's a maintenance issue at property, rather than going all the way out there, and sometimes a picture does, just one picture doesn't do it justice, and get on a video call and get to the root of the issue and find out what's going on. So that's one way. Of course, traditional telephone, we speak by telephone, emails, and all of that sort of stuff. But I'd say to get that human interaction, video call is our preferred method.
Would you say that you have a particular kind of, do you work very closely with a particular demographic of landlords and tenants, or do you find that actually everybody wants this kind of service, or do you find that you have to focus quite specifically on who it is that you talk to and propose this service to?
Yeah, I mean, for us as a business, we do have a target client that we're looking for, a target landlord that we're looking for. And there's loads of different types of landlords. You've got your buy-to-let investor, you've got your career landlord. And then for us, we're more targeting the accidental landlords, and a demographic that's probably a bit younger, and through circumstances have now got into a position where they have to let out their property or sell it. Obviously, our preference would be that they're looking to let it. So we're talking about landlords who maybe live in a property. They might live in a one-bedroom flat, and because of a job move, maybe, for example, they have to move out, but then they don't want to give up their property. Or potentially they're getting married, and because they're getting married, they're moving out, or they're just moving because they want to have a bigger space. But it's about a change in circumstance that has brought this about. So this isn't somebody who has set out to be a landlord. So this is a person who probably has no idea what it means to be a landlord, has no idea what it takes, what the roles and responsibilities are, what legislation's in place so that they can ensure that their property is compliant. This is the landlord that is clueless, basically, hasn't got a clue, needs somebody to come in and save the day, basically.
I guess that being online and with that being more of the focus of how you communicate with your landlords, perhaps it makes it a little bit easier. Do you think that it's that more immediate communication they can perhaps have with you? I do appreciate that in any situation they can pick up the phone and speak to somebody, but the fact that you're readily available via Zoom, do you think that it's that immediacy really that gives them a bit more confidence in coming to you, being perhaps not that used to the industry?
I think it does give them confidence, but on top of that, I think more importantly is the convenience of it. I think for a lot of people, particularly younger people, and when I say young, I really mean between the ages of maybe 25 to maybe 40, in that sort of age range. They're very, very used to using mobile phones and tablets to get services and stuff like that. So I think, yes, it does give them confidence, but also the convenience of it. You can go on the website and there's a chatbot available. That's another touch point that I didn't touch on as well. So these little things make it easy. It's about making it easy. And I think for a lot of landlords, when something is made easy and simple, it does inspire trust. It's not complicated. And it does give them a sense of, whew, okay, I can leave it with these guys. These guys know what they're doing.
You've mentioned that, like your chatbot, there is a lot of technology out there that can help support you in offering this service. That's kind of the point of technology, I think. Obviously, with Good Lord, we provide that technology to letting agents as well. And the idea is not so much to take away any form of control, but actually to give you back control, give you an easier way of doing things. So I guess it's a similar thing to what you were just saying. But what kinds of technologies did you kind of set up from day one, and did you recognize would be important, not just for yourselves, making it a bit more efficient perhaps, but then obviously delivering that service to your customers?
I'll be honest, when I first started, I didn't have a clue what to look out for. It was literally just a case of going online and digging around to find solutions, to be honest with you. So did I have in mind exactly what I wanted to provide for clients? No, I didn't. But it was about looking to other industries because, again, this sort of thing is not very popular in the property industry, digitizing things and doing things virtually and doing things, you know, from a tech point of view. So it was about looking at other industries and looking how they service their clients and looking at how we can incorporate that into the property industry. So things like the chatbot, for example, if you go looking for a particular piece of software, for example, you'll find that a lot of those types of industries, software industries, they service their clients with a lot of technology because they are a technology business themselves. And the experience I had with that, in terms of the ease, the convenience, in terms of the quality of the service overall, made me feel that actually this is something we can incorporate. So that me coming across a chatbot was just me going on a website looking for services for myself and thinking, hang on a second, this is something I can provide to clients as well.
Now that makes complete sense, and it's true, I guess, that if you went out there and thought that's the service that I want, and then you look for ways of replicating that almost that level of service in your own business, that is completely the right way to do it. Obviously, it's you want to provide what you'd expect from other places as well.
Absolutely.
Were there any other industries? I mean, where else did you gain this kind of inspiration as to how to do things? Whether it's just, you know, like the technology focus at large, or whether it's more specific in terms of the, you know, the chatbot, for example, that you discovered.
Again, it was just about Google searching. So it wasn't like I delved into any industry specifically. But when you're doing a Google search, you're on a software website one time, then you're on an accounting website, then you're on a cybersecurity website. You're just darting all over the place when you're trying to start a business. But what you start to find, particularly with a lot of forward-thinking businesses, is just different ways of doing things. So yeah, I did mention the chatbot. Another one was there's a lot of AI. That's another thing. So for example, this is definitely one for the future, but something we do as part of our business is every tenancy that's set up, for example, we set up a WhatsApp group. So we've got, you know, let's say we've got John and Emma and they've moved into an apartment. We've set up a WhatsApp group for them. And now what you can do is generate videos with AI using script. So what we've done is like a welcome to your property type video. And what that video details is how to be a tenant with us at Propfinity, what our expectations are, what you need to do if you need help, where you need to pay your rent, what to do if there's an emergency, all of these sorts of details that nobody really wants to read on small print, but a video captures it in a captivating way and an engaging way and gets all of the information across. That's another example of something that I came across that I've used and incorporated in my business. It would generate like a avatar, looks very realistic, and the avatar would talk and demonstrate, and obviously you can add embellishments to the videos and text and graphics and all sorts of things to make it more engaging. And that's another example of something that we've used. So a tenant can watch it, understand what they need to know, where they need to go, and everything like that during a tenancy. And that's another example of a piece of technology that sort of overcomes the issue where it comes to reading things on small print or reading things in contracts. We know a lot of people don't like to read everything, but that video gets all of the messages across.
No, I mean, that must help you as well. I mean, you want these people to read this information, you know, to make sure it doesn't cause any issues later down the road. So it's a perfect example of something which does obviously bring a great benefit to tenants, and but also to yourselves as well. So
Absolutely.
No, it must be quite exciting then, coming into, you know, deciding you're going to set up your own company, realizing that it's this digital way forwards would work for the types of, you know, landlords, tenants that you're going to be working with. And then just realizing that you've just got this broad spectrum of possibilities really that you can look for and decide, okay, what will work for us, what won't work for us, what will work in particular for our tenants and landlords. It must be quite exciting coming into that environment.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And it's exciting because the possibilities are endless. I think with AI is another one that's going to be very, very interesting to see how we can incorporate AI into the property industry. I've got a few ideas in my mind of things that can definitely, I think that could be possible. Is it possible potentially that you could have a letting agent without estate agents? Could you let your property digitally? Can you do viewings digitally maybe, and have people view property without an agent? I think these are all things that can possibly happen.
Well, I guess that, as you said at the beginning, the fact that you sort of started during the pandemic, and I think that was quite a moment really where people did realize the potential for a lot of these different technologies and the way that they could be used, well, in different ways or more than they had been in the past. I guess that was quite a grand experiment really, and you've kind of taken it and run with it a little bit further,
absolutely.
Which is great to see.
That's exactly it, yeah.
And just thinking back on the fact that you are kind of working with these accidental landlords as the demographic really that you've recognised that this, your particular model will work for. It's quite interesting because obviously right now you hear it across the board really that there are these supply issues, demand is super high, potentially the accidental landlords are the ones that are kind of losing out in the current circumstances in terms of the regulation and so on that's out there. Are you finding that because this is your chosen demographic, are you still finding that that's a segment that's growing, particularly if you're looking at expanding nationally?
That's a good question. I would say that I think it's a demographic that's growing. And to be honest, throughout my career as an estate agent, most of the clients that I've come across are accidental landlords. And it's probably a smaller percentage than you might think that are actual buy-to-let investors. And that's what my experience has been anyway. So I do tend to find when I go on valuations, most of the time it's I need to go abroad for work, or I need a bigger house, or my family circumstances has changed and I need to move back in with my parents and things like that. So I would say that the market definitely is still there.
And with you being quite digitally focused, whereabouts is it that you kind of, how do you attract new landlords to you? Is it something that you go out there? Do you go out in person? Do you go out online, social media? You know, where are your main, marketing activities that you put out there?
Absolutely. So again, digital marketing is the number one for us. Social media, Google ads, sponsored ads on Google, Facebook, Instagram, all of that sort of thing. So whilst we do some traditional forms of marketing in terms of like leaflet dropping and stuff like that, that's more to supplement the online marketing. I think that's the most important thing for us. That's where most of our leads come from. That's where most of our landlords come from. You can't get away from things like word of mouth and referrals. That stuff will happen. You will get leads that way as well. But in terms of our brand and winning business and marketing strategy, it's primarily Google, and then secondarily it's Facebook, Instagram.
Well, it makes sense if you're out there, the service you're providing is in the digital sphere. If you're looking for people to come and use your services in that same sphere, it makes complete sense to do that. With it being digital first from the beginning, starting your own business, I'm assuming that one of part of the attractiveness of starting this digitally focused business will be the costs. You know, if you don't have branches and so on, you don't necessarily have those overheads. Do you think that it is an easier way to get into the industry, perhaps for other letting agents that work in the field and they're looking at setting up their own business as well?
Absolutely. I think, a lot more businesses have come into effect just because of technology. You know, it's very daunting to have to find premises, then have to refurbish it, and then get furniture for it, and then get your computers and your office chairs and all of that sort of stuff. That can set you back 25, 50, maybe £100,000 as a setup cost. And my setup cost was nowhere near that. It's a monthly subscription with some tech companies that can allow me to work and provide my service to my customers. So cost is a massive thing. And obviously technology, just because you can scale it and use it in a way that you can't when you've got actual bodies in an office, it just makes it a lot cheaper. Makes it a lot more affordable, and not just affordable, more reliable and easier to manage, and it's more trustworthy, because a lot of the tasks, the administrative tasks that sometimes can be prone to human error, just isn't there. But I know your question was mainly about the costing. It is a lot more affordable, and it will allow a lot more agents to pop up and provide services in their local area, or, you know, regionally or nationally, because the barriers that were there before in terms of costs, simple piece of technology can just get rid of it.
I know that my question was about costs, but you raised a couple of quite relevant, very interesting points, and obviously the time factor, the fact that you've got a lot of it taken care of by that technology in the background, as well as reduced errors and things like that. Is that the kind of thing that you bring into your conversations with landlords, and actually do you have to convince them of the benefits of being digitally led, or do they kind of come to you ready prepared because that's what they're used to, I guess, in day-to-day life?
I think, you know, when you're going on evaluation and you're meeting with a landlord, particularly a landlord that, you know, is worried and doesn't know what to expect or where to go, they are an open book. They are ready to soak in anything you give to them. And for us, I know that when we go meet with a landlord, we're definitely going to offer them something unique and something different. So it's not a case of having to convince them. I think people understand that technology is what most companies use in terms of providing a service. So I think when we come to evaluation, I think we stand out. I think we're going to be different from the high street option. So it's not a case of having to convince them. It's more a case of telling them what we have to offer and getting them excited. And they will get excited because it's different, it's unique, it's forward thinking, it's revolutionary. And it's what the rest of the world seemed to be doing, except the property industry was still stuck getting people into branches and signing contracts and photocopying people's passports and proof of address, when all of the stuff can be verified digitally online, you know. So, no, it's not a case of having to convince them. It's just a case of just letting them know this is what we do. And they're going to like it because the technology is so good.
And off the back of that, what are your predictions for kind of where the industry is going in that sense? You know, not necessarily in terms of growth and things, but in terms of branches versus fully online. Do you think that we will ever get to the point where it's solely online, or do we think that there's still always going to be that place for the you know, the in-person meetups in branches?
I think it really boils down to how well and how effective online agencies are in terms of delivering their service. I think if we can prove to the market we are better, I think, like with Blockbuster, like with HMV and all of these branches and businesses that were high street based, I think may become redundant, obsolete. You might not see them. It's hard to really say. We might have a market that's a hybrid where it's 50-50. So, you know, with things like, I would say if we look at the fashion industry, we have ASOS, you've got Pretty Little Things, you've got online clothing store, but that hasn't completely gotten rid of Primark and Marks and Spencer. But I think there have been some closures of like a Debenhams, for example, and things like that. So it's about competition. and it's about winning the competition. But the technology is so good, so convenient, and it just seems to me that's the direction where things will go eventually. So I, if you're asking for my prediction, I think at some point, one way or another, the technology will win, and the agents that are using the technology to lead in terms of delivering their service, I think, will be the preferred agent to go to.
Yeah, I think it's a lot of agents are starting to recognize that. You know, I mean, you know, like Good Lord, for example, we've been around for a fair number of years now, and I think that we've only grown in that time. So it's it is kind of, yeah, the direction of travel, I think, for the industry. And I think that, you know, rent tech providers, they there are a lot of them for agents to choose from and kind of decide, okay, what would fit my business, what would fit the service that we want to provide and things like that. So yeah, there are lots of opportunities out there. Just perhaps to start to wrap up our conversation and to perhaps try and summarize a little bit of it, I mean, what would you say are the key things that landlords are looking for in a letting agent today?
I think the most important thing is as an agent that they can trust. I think for a lot of landlords, their home is their most expensive asset. It's their most expensive investment. It's the thing that they care about the most. It's the thing that they've got the, you know, the most emotional attachment to outside of friends and family. So they need somebody that they can trust. Also, for a lot of landlords, once the property is rented, that property is going to cover the cost of the mortgage. And if that goes wrong, that can be very, very crippling. You know, if you've not chosen the right agent, an agent that's trustworthy and isn't then going to treat your property as they would their own, yeah, that can be financially crippling. There are stories of landlords who, you know, have gone for an agent purely because it's the cheapest agent, and they're having to pay their mortgage as well as the mortgage on the investment property, for example. And that can be emotionally, yes, and financially challenging. And one of the ways technology can deliver that, because technology, it is so much less prone to error than humans, it is then intrinsically more trustworthy than a human, particularly for administrative tasks. Not so much for, you know, getting on the phone and building a relationship. The tech, you've got humans that are better suited for that. But I'll give an example. Compliance is huge in property. You get compliance wrong, you're going to have a lot of issues as a landlord. So, for example, when you're moving a tenant in, going through the letting process, there are certain tick boxes you need to check off in order to ensure that, you know, the tenancy is compliant. So, for example, you need to make sure that you get the prescribed information signed off. You need to make sure your gas safety, electric safety certificate, your energy performance certificate, you need to ensure those things are sent off to the tenant. The deposit certificate, you need to make sure that is also sent off to the tenant. So with you guys, especially Good Lord, the platform you provide for us allows us to be compliant. So it then means, for example, in the absolute worst case scenario, let's say we're going to have to evict a tenant out of a property because that tenant's not paying rent, right? We now need to go down the legal route. When you go down the legal route, the judge wants to know, is the tenancy compliant? Because if the tenancy is not compliant, irrespective of whether the tenant's paid rent or not, you haven't done your job, Mr. Landlord. So we're going to have to throw this out of court. We're going to throw this case out and the tenant wins. Even though the tenant hasn't paid rent, but just because you haven't been compliant, you're now going to have to wait another 6 months down the line before you can actually evict your tenant, right? So this is why I'm bringing it back to trust. This is why trust is so important, because if it all goes wrong, it's going to be a huge, huge issue. So linking the trust and the tech will do the job for you. The tech will make sure that the tenancy is compliant. It will make sure you send the EPC and the gas safety certificate. It will make sure you send a deposit certificate. It will make sure that the prescribed information is signed and sent to the tenant. All of these sorts of things are vital, imperative, important, insert any adjective you need to insert for important. It's so important that it gets done, because ultimately the most important thing is ensuring that your client is serviced properly and that you are delivering a service that, yeah, a landlord can trust. It's really that simple.
No, it does seem to be a key word, and it is interesting how, like, the trust needs to be there regardless, irrespective of whether you're using the technology to give them that trust or not. But it is interesting hearing how you talk about the support that that technology can give. And my final question, which, to be fair, I think you probably just answered, it was really to what would you say to those agents who are perhaps a little nervous about jumping in and using technology, perhaps updating some of their systems to help support them through that process? I mean, would you have any kind of tips or advice for those agents that are perhaps on the fence and considering using technology but haven't quite made that jump yet?
I would say get on a call to any tech-based service providers. Let them give you the information about how their tech can help save you money, how it can help save you time, how it can help you be more compliant, and how it can provide a better service to you so that you can provide a better service to your client. So I would say get on a call with these providers and see what they have to offer, because that's all I did, particularly with GoodLord. GoodLord was an accident. I never, ever planned to use GoodLord. It was just a Google search and looking around. And I thought to myself, do you know what? Let's just give them a call. And I gave them a call, and here I am. So I would say be open and give the technology a chance.
That is a perfect close, I think, to our conversation. I don't think I need to summarize anymore.
Perfect.
No, so thanks ever so much then, David. I do think that that's been a very interesting conversation. I think it will, we've really kind of outlined that kind of modern letting agent, that concepts that landlords and tenants can look to use. So yeah, I appreciate you taking the time to talk through it with me.
No, absolutely. It's a pleasure. Thanks for the time. Thanks for the call. And thanks for the conversation.
Thank you.